Hey guys, welcome back to Nebraska. We're out here. If you can see, I'm kind of pulling a fertilizer tote today. I'm going to set up a fertigation unit on one of our pivots. And what that is we can actually irrigate through our pivots. If you haven't seen before, I was one of my videos back, I was recalculating a pivot to kind of figure out how long it takes to make a circle, so we can make the calculations on how to basically how fast the pivot goes in a circle, so we can calculations the gallons per minute we have to run and how we want to basically spread this stuff out through a pivot. And so if you want to flip back through that, that's kind of how we set up the calculations. I'll leave a link above here. What we're going to do is I'm going to pull this out to a pivot point and set up a pump that'll inject it in kind of a measured manner into the pivot, and then it'll kind of, and what it does is there'll be a mister, and I'll show you that here in a second, but what that'll do is mist it in that valve instead of just kind of shooting streams. That way it gets through all that, it permeates the water, and so it's a nice even blend through that water that's going through the pivot. But yeah, what we're going to do today is set it up for, I'm running 5 gallons of 32% along with 2 gallons of thiosol. And so 7 gallons an acre total over like a 130 acre pivot is what we're setting this up for. And so that'll take 910 gallon, and that's how much is in that tote right now behind me that I'm pulling. And so yeah, we're going to pull that to the center point and hopefully get that set up, and we'll see how that works there. The corn's kind of come back, but we'll attempt her. Stuff like this always helps for the resale value. That's why I chose silver. All right, pulling up on the well area. At least it ain't super weedy yet. Goal is not to try to run it over with it. Some corn will be sacrificed. Okay, so what, I got 2 pumps back here. These are made by Neptune, agri-inject carpopulins. Also, these are kind of manual ones. I know now, one of the ones I'd like to try sometime are Surefire. They're more computerized, they program themselves, and they also work through like AgSense systems to kind of remotely monitor more. These are more basic, but they still do a good job once you get them set for the gallonage. They usually come pretty close. The only problem is you don't know if they ever shut off or there's no remote monitoring with these. And so this one right here is rated at 100 gallon, this one an hour, and this one right here is at 30 gallon per hour. So these work. This one works well enough for our older pivots with like short tires that just can't make a circle fast enough, where this one works well for a pivot like this that can pretty much boogie around with the tall tires and newer gearboxes and stuff. They can just go a little bit faster. And so we can really crank this down. Right now, it's 10 o'clock, and so I kind of want to set it so I can come check it. It should shut off, you know, I'll be done with it tomorrow at 8, so I'll set it for like 22 hours. And so you can do whatever you want, and as long as your capacity can handle it. But we'll hook this up to this fertilizer tank right here. And then what we'll do here is, this is called a chemigation valve again. And what this does is there's a flip valve in here that, so when your water flows through, it opens up. But when it shuts off, it won't let any water come back. And what that allows us to do is put chemical or fertilizer through here without the worry of it backing up into the well. And that helps us protect our groundwater and stuff like that. Also, those electric pumps back there, they will run on 480 volts. And so what we do, let's hopefully clean that out.
Should get a plug. Some of them have better weather tight seals. This one isn't. Cheaper plug, but it is what it is. And so yeah, you run three phase power through those pumps. I can just turn this switch on here. And also the pivot point's up there, so I'll have to walk through a little bit of corn. And then that's what we'll set our time at. Figure I better clean that plug out since I actually got the stuff here. So before I get this going, this is what a version of a mister valve looks like. And what that does is this will pulse through here as it pumps. So it kind of, it pulse pumps. So what this will do is when that comes through, it creates a mist, and it'll mist it out through that pipe. So it mixes through that water a lot better than just kind of streaming through a little bit. This is where we'll unscrew and screw this in. And some of these come with bleeder valves, but I just find it easiest to let the air out and then shove it in. It's just less area for this. Sometimes those can break and stuff and whatnot. So that's how I do it. There's other ways to do it. Everybody's probably got an opinion, but that's how I set mine up anyway. The steel ones are meant for more gallons. As you get to smaller gallons like this one, you can get away with little cheaper plastic ones, but that's kind of how there's, so there's different variations of mister valves. Right now though, I need to make sure the well has adequate drip oil, so I got me a little gallon jug here enough to do a circle here. And so this is how this well is lubricated. The pump system on it is, I haven't touched this yet this year, so it just kind of gets that oily film and everything sticks to it. But this deal right here, you fill it up with drip oil, it drips out through here, and then it goes down inside that pump, and then that's what lubricates that pump as you drip it. Oh, anywhere from every 3 to 10 seconds. It ranges throughout the day just by your temperatures, but you just want to make sure it's dripping adequately enough. On these plastic ones, I usually leave the lid cracked just a little bit, just because it sometimes these vents are doesn't work very well, and that'll actually cause that to stop. So I leave these a little loose so air can get in them. And then we'll get this started here. I don't know if you can see this. I actually do winterize these pumps, because we don't store them in a heated shop. In order to start this well, it's controlled by the pivot, so it tells it when it's to come on and off. And so we turn that to auto, and that allows the pivot to control and everything. If we just want the well to run, we can turn it over to hand and start it. But yeah, we want this controlled by the pivot, basically, to tell it when to turn on and off. So I'm gonna have this pivot is controlled by an app or by a pivot monitor. And so I'm gonna run this on 100%, which allows me to run that monitor on any percentage I want. And so I'm gonna do that, turn our main power on, got our volts. I'm gonna run this forward. We want our water supply on, we want our system power on. Then we're gonna start this baby. You're gonna hear it, should hear the well take off. I don't know if you can hear that through this remote or not. All right, we should be live. So now I'm gonna do my math. And I'll get this all set up, I'll figure out where it needs to be, then we'll set the pivot through the iPhone app, get it timed right. I need to be running, I think, roughly around 41 gallon, but I'll redo my math here. That's gonna do it on the way down. Okay, so I figured out to run 22 hours, I need to be running around that 41 gallon. So since this is a 100 gallon pump, it kind of makes the percentage over here fairly easy. So I need to turn this down to basically 40 and then find it from there. I don't know if you can see these numbers right here, but right now I'm on 40, and then these are the actual incremental ones. So I might kind of start around 40 and a half. I'd rather kind of be a touch light personally than a touch heavy, because then you run out. So yeah, I usually leave a little room for error, so I might even set it just at 40 for now. I was gonna set up the phone, but I don't have much service, so I'll wait till I get outside the pivot up on top of a hill so I can actually set the pivot speed by that. One thing I do like to do is make a small minuscule mark on the tank where it started, just so when I come back out here to check it later today, I got a good idea where it kind of started at. So I just take a little pin, it'll wash off since it's not really our tank. Actually, I'll do it back here. Then I'll write the exact time, just so I know I can do some calculations when I come back out here. So it's 10:25. That way we know we're doing it correctly when I come back out here to see how many gallons has gone down. So another thing we check and see is everything's working right. You can see it pressured up. As you can see, the water gets heavier out the end. And I don't know if you can even tell, but the end gun's even running. So it's all a good sign. This is the pivot we're starting. I don't know how well you can see this, but I'm gonna go through. And I have a way I can set a flat rate. And I wanna come in, I can either do it by percentage wise, or I can even come in here and set the time. So I'm gonna set it for 22 hours. And then it figures it all out for me then, if I have the time entered in correctly in the default settings for this pivot, basically. So you gotta actually have it timed right for it to know this. And so, yeah, you just can't go off of just guessing, but, so yeah, once I got that figured out, I can just type in 22 hours. Where it started from, I'm gonna set that place to stop, so it makes a perfect circle and then stop, so I don't have to worry about it, keep going, and then I can actually see if I ran out or didn't run out beforehand. And so yeah, I'll come back later today to check it out, see how it's doing, to make sure it's going right, and then go from there. It's been 3 hours roughly, and so I'm gonna see, make sure it's down. It should be down 40-80, about 120 gallon maybe roughly in there. So we're gonna check it out, see how it is. Loaded up the Japanese horse back there. I don't know if you can see it or not, but we're gonna head out. Check it out. I don't know, some of you might be wondering if running fertilizer through your pivot will burn your corn. And the deal is we're running so little amount of fertilizer through the pipe, because this well right now is kicking out at roughly 750 to 800 gallons per minute. That pump is only pumping 40 gallon per hour. And so the actual, you know, what you're putting into that pipe is very minimal, so it never causes burn to the plant. It's a very minimal amount, so I guess that's how you answer that in too many words, I guess. All right, guys, it's the next day. Let's see what we got. So it got down to the bottom here. I don't know if you can see the level. Maybe could have had a little bit heavier, but I'm gonna call that good enough. That's kind of how this works. All right, so we got the second one going. It's the same tank and everything. I'm just doing one at a time because we're gonna have to go lay out some pipe here pretty soon, but this is kind of how it sets up here. Goes into this one right here. We're injecting. The only thing is the power is actually coming from the panel on this one. There's ways you can hook it up there so it shuts off when the pivot shuts off, because you want it to be able to shut off, because you don't want to leave this run and just fill up the pipe full of fertilizer. And so you want to have the safeties all set right, so nothing's running if the safety, or if the pivot safety's out. So that's something to always think about when you're fertigating, is, I mean, and you kind of have to have it set up that way. So, yep, that's how that goes. So we're gonna get out of here. So right now we are laying out pipe. Got the beautiful Mrs. O'Neill at the other end. Wave. That was the weakest wave ever. Then we got Boss Man here. Can you say hey, boss? Hi, guys. All right. A couple of these I got to put gaskets in. As you can see here, I took them out. They just get dry rotted over the years. And yeah, you just got to replace them or else they will leak. And so I need some new ones, bud.
Okay.
Here we go. Here's a new one. Nope, that ain't a new one. You're supposed to be on top of this. Let's break this one open here. So this one's a Rainway gasket. That's the brand name of it. They're kind of a skinnier square gasket, I guess. Squared edge. Go like that. What we gotta do here, we gotta stretch a pipe that we gotta lay out here that actually won't have any gates in it. And we call that mainline pipe. That's just what we've always called it, or what I've been told anyway. So it's a piece of the field that, you know, we won't ever have to open gates or whatnot. So we'll lay that out along here first. And then when we get around the corner and start going down rows, then we'll start putting out pipe that has gates. The benefits of mainline pipe is you don't have any gates to go bad or leak. So that's what we do there. Hey guys, this is it for this video. So thanks for watching. Hopefully I'm not wasting your time. Yeah, if you want to know any more, just ask a question in the comments below, or let me know how you guys do it, or just whatever you want to ask or say, just leave it in the comments below. And if you like it enough, please hit subscribe, like, and do all that good stuff. So yeah, once again, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.